item number two. I would like to move item number two to the very end of the meeting right before adjournment.
And I don't want to do that.
Well, I think we're going to have a lot of discussion, and I really want to go through the rest of these things and save that until last. So I'm going to make a motion that we move item number two to the end of the meeting right before adjournment. May I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor of the motion to move item number two to the end of the meeting, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
No.
That item passes 4-1 with Commissioner Moses being opposed.
Okay, I just wanted to go back to something I didn't get to discuss on. I started to begin to discuss it, but I do want to, in fairness, just like I think you were trying to be fair to people that are here by moving item two to the back, I'm just wondering how many people are here for item two. Anybody here for item two? Just one? Okay. Two? Three? So there are people that you're inconveniencing by putting it back to the back.
Well, I think that it's going to be a longer discussion, which is why I made the motion. It was seconded, and we voted to move it.
I understand that. I'm just trying to let you know that there, you know, there are people that that's kind of inconveniencing too.
All right. Thank you.
You know, I was just trying to take them into account.
Thanks. The next one is the item that we moved, which is rezoning affidavit statement. Commissioner Moses.
Can start off with a quick introduction, if that's acceptable.
Can you? Moses. Oh, yes.
Passing around the product that came through our email to you.
Oh, in your, just humor me on one thing. Tom,
yes.
In your introduction, I would love for you to read us what the UDC says about public hearings and recommendations in Chapter 4, 2.7. I've got it right here if you want to read that. When you're going through that, I'd like you just to read the rule.
Well, my introduction will be brief. This was emailed out to you. We discussed this general concept last month. The direction I took away from the PC meeting was you wanted a fairly basic product. And, following that meeting, some of you are aware, the issue was indirectly discussed at the Board of Commissioners at a work session regarding some concern about county resources and where resources were being spent, and you have a letter from the chairman
here
to the chairman of the planning commission about that.
Yeah.
That continued to build along the theme of minimizing the resources we spent on this. I had originally anticipated that this probably would have looked more like a memo with the text stuck in the middle of it, and an introduction and a conclusion. What Ken gave me was the simplest product he could prepare, which was stealing this page out of the UDC, typing in two sentences up, I say off the top of his head. He's an intelligent guy. Off the top of his head is the equivalent of a lot of research on my part. So he stuck it in here. This would, if the Planning Commission decided we wanted to recommend this to the Board of Commissioners, and then if the Board of Commissioners decided they wanted to act on this as far as doing an ordinance change, it is at that point in time all the additional work would come in, actually creating all the forms, updating all of our applications, establishing the procedure of how all these things would move through the process, when they would get checked and verified, and how much research. I know this one has Vanessa nervous, how much research would take place at the staff level of verifying these facts. So that's where we're at on this. Jody has asked me to talk about Chapter 4 of the UDC.
4.2.7, if you could just read that.
4.2.7, the entire paragraph, can we read?
Well, you can read up until about halfway through it, because
public, this is the chapter on the Planning Commission, public hearings and recommendations. The Planning Commission is hereby delegated by the Board of Commissioners the responsibility of conducting public hearings on specific applications for an amendment to the official zoning map as required by Georgia law. The Planning Commission is also authorized to conduct and shall conduct public hearings on applications for conditional use permits. The Planning Commission may make recommendations to the Board regarding the amendments to the comprehensive plan, text of this code, and the official zoning map, and applications for conditional use permits.
So will you read that last sentence one more time?
The Planning Commission may make recommendations to the Board regarding amendments to the comp plan and text of this code.
Okay, so it doesn't say, it says that the way we do this is to make a recommendation to the Board of Commissioners. It doesn't say that we go like the chairman of the commission wants us to do, which does not comply with the UDC. What he's requesting was that we circumvent.
No, I'm not going to agree with that.
He was requesting that we don't abide by.
That's not what I read into
it's
it.
Not what he said.
Okay, he's requesting that the proposed concept be placed on a Board of Commission work session and ratified. Can you show me in the UDC where it says that's the way to do it?
I see the focus in this letter as being on the resources of my department and Ken's office, mm-hmm. and not in any way limiting your ability to come up with your own recommendations.
Okay. Well,
are you finished with your introduction?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Can I ask a quick question? Because when I saw the work session, I watched their work session after our work session, and went back to then watch our work session, thanks to Miss Nydia. And what I brought out from that was that things must have gotten done that we didn't approve. Because we just asked for information about it. Tom gave a very specific, the task is very limited. It is not drafting any forms or any UDC changes. It is a 1 to 2 page document that Mr. Moses will put together. It did not include spending time with Ken. In the minutes, the motion was just to place the discussion of this matter on the November work session. It was not to bring it to the Board of Commissioners. So I was confused as to how it got from that to their
work session.
Confusion.
That's why
it's
I brought.
It's not supposed to be up there.
That's why I brought this. This is what transpired, and I wrote it down from their minutes from their work session on 10/22, where a motion was made and seconded by another commissioner, and the discussion is regarding procedure to take items through the chain of command to the county attorney. That's what their issue was. And then the discussion follows, and I gave you each a copy of what the minutes reflected as to their discussion. It had to do with the amount of time that the county attorney and our staff had spent on something that they felt that we had directed them to do.
Let me assure this
board. They clearly did not.
No.
Let me assure this board. Right here now, that these two sentences that Ken put in here and the amount of time that Tom put on it may be 10 minutes. How much time do you think it took Ken?
What I'm questioning is that
y'all give me an opportunity to present this to the board like I'm supposed to before you start.
I had a question about our work session before you were going to go into that.
Okay.
So
well, maybe Tom
can't
well Pam that going.
Well, you need to let her finish what she's saying so that she can finish.
You were the
finish.
One that started talking.
No, really, I'm not.
Okay.
Why doesn't Tom answer the question?
I'm all for it. You getting your question answered? Didn't you address it to Tom as to what?
My question was, how much time do the commissioners think was spent on this?
Well, I was not at that work session because that was an item that was added.
None of us were.
That was added at the meeting. I didn't know about it in advance. I heard about it. I watched the video like a lot of you, and I was concerned. I was very concerned as well that there was a perception that both Ken's office and my office were spending significant amounts of time on the planning commission while we were ignoring the board of commissioners, and that is, it's not accurate.
So why would that information get put out?
I was also a little concerned that they envisioned this product we're discussing tonight as something much more elaborate than it was.
Well, when I called you, I thought it was much more elaborate until you explained it to me.
You know, it was one of those things, the fact that it got stuck in, you know, and pasted in this document was just, sometimes it's easier to stick two sentences in the text than it is to draft a memo and describe where it would go and describe how you put it.
I guess my confusion was why Ken was doing that at all, because we never, our direction was not, no, if you watch our work session, it was not.
Listen to the boss here.
I'm not the boss of the planning commission.
I know, the planning department. Listen to.
I do feel like that meeting, you said Ken was going to work on it.
Very specifically, I wrote down exactly what you said, which was, the motion was to do a fairly limited outline, not drafting UDC changes, not creating every form. I see a 1 to 2 page document that can land on their agenda upstairs in a work session. That was it.
How about two sentences?
That was not the motion, though.
No, the motion was to place further discussion of this matter on the November work session. That was the only motion we made.
And there was...
Per the minutes that we received. Which is fine. We went originally talking to Ken about it. He said something about, we've pretty much discussed, I've given you the information I feel like I need to give you. You said there really wasn't much need to...
We discussed it after the work session last month.
And I thought Jody was going to be the, take the bull by the horns, and he was going to do that. He was going to present us with information so that we could make a decision if we were going to move forward with
That's
it.
That's right.
Not go straight to UDC changes. That
Jody
was my
last
confusion.
Month. Okay. Speaking
let me,
of the
let
full
me.
Planning commission, asking that I be allowed to discuss with our council and come up with a plan
that was originally
to the board of commissioners
Absolutely.
In the form of a recommendation.
That was originally, and then we went back from that, and you gave him very clear instructions, and I felt like we were directing him to do what you told him to do.
Well, I think then it's an example of needing to look at how we make motions at this meeting.
Because
what we have is, we have
I absolutely agree.
2 pages of back and forth, and the actual text was, I make a motion. May I have a second? Second. Mm-hmm. So...
And
when
on
we have
the
that,
minutes
who,
are,
who
and then
made
a month
that
later,
motion?
We're scratching our head out.
Okay, so that means y'all want me to get a little bit more vocal with my motions. I'm trying, you know.
I think anyone in the planning commission, we all can have more focus on motions because, as an example of,
but you're
five minutes,
the whole
5 minutes of discussion concluded by someone saying, I make a motion, second. Just it's so conducive to us getting here a month later saying, I didn't think that's what I heard.
Right.
And someone saying, I heard the exact opposite. And the truth is, everyone heard that because they all heard different parts.
Yeah.
And the motion
so what would you like to see?
That's what
I think that's right. In my opinion, how it got there.
No, that's
but
good.
That's not what was meant.
No,
and that's
no,
not what I meant.
And
I'm the one, as you said,
and
I'm
I think that what happened here also is that Commissioner Mills received an email from someone who alluded to what the planning commission was going to do with the UDC, and it snowballed from there and got completely blown out of proportion. And when I was talked to about it, that's what I told them, is that this just has gotten all blown
Who
out of proportion. Several people.
Well, how did it get to all that? Is Cindy
from the work session? This is what happened at the work session. She made a motion to add it on there. They talked about it during that time period, and
then
it was on the consent agenda at the public hearing for the letter to be written. But that's how it all got started.
Well, there you go. And I want everybody to know I had nothing to do with any of that. I was emailed what Cindy said, but Cindy got into a discussion with somebody else, and they were having a discussion, and I think way at the very end, I chimed in when Cindy seemed to understand that everything was fine. But why did Cindy have to bring it, why did Cindy have to bring it up? I mean, y'all could have gotten me sidetracked here, which is fine. It's just going to keep us here long. But why would, did you talk to Cindy?
You have to ask Cindy.
I talked to her briefly.
So why would she bring it up at the Board of Commissioners and get it kind of out of whack from this nice orderly process that we had lined up?
I think the concern is the expenditure of funds.
The concern was the funds and spending.
Okay, well, let me address that. Now, I'm going to address it and let me talk now.
They had specific things that they wanted the attorney and the planning department to be working on, and didn't want them to neglect their wishes and wants to jump and do this for us. I think that's it. Tom, is that the gist of what you got?
Yes, it was about resources. It wasn't about a particular change may have sparked it, but the discussion was not about the particular change.
No, it was about the resources.
There are, I mean, if I understand correctly.
Hold on. It's my turn. Excuse me, I've been trying. I mean, just give me, you can talk in a minute.
I haven't talked to you.
Because I've tried and I've been chastised two or three times. So I'm going to butt in. I'm going to read one thing that I've got to say about this. Pete's letter is after the fact. And is a diversion from what we're trying to do here. The planning department and legal work on this proposal was extremely minimal. Think 10 minutes. And has already been done before Pete's letter ever got thought about and before Cindy ever got involved. It was already done, maybe 10 minutes total. Therefore, there's really no need for Pete to have written a letter. I mean, his letter is superfluous. And now there's really no need for Cindy to have brought it up to the Board of Commissioners, because that's what we're trying to do, is bring it up. Now, as far as the cost, Pete's letter probably cost a lot more than was spent getting the initiative on the Planning Commission agenda. So obviously this is not about money or time spent, as is being proposed in the letter. The letter is, as I said, it's a diversion. We're sitting here talking about everything except the proposal.
Because we haven't gotten to that yet.
That's what I'm saying. And we've been diverted by this letter that wasn't necessary, and it's all wrong.
Well, but it happened.
That letter cost more money to prepare than anything that Tom and Ken Gerard or I put together.
Because well, that letter,
they're hyperventilating down there. It cost the county more money than anything.
Did they ever ask? No, I understand how much time was actually spent.
So why does Cindy and Pete get so upset that they're sending those letters?
What was your question, Jane?
I had asked Tom before, which was not answered. How did they ever ask you how much time was spent, and did you give them an estimated time spent? Or
I discussed it in a good amount of detail with our chairman, Pete Amos, and Cindy Mills, who was the person who brought the item up after that work session. It wasn't there, but after the fact, I did discuss it to them. Did my best to inform them that we weren't drafting complete code changes down here, and that the Planning Commission is operating the same way it did a decade ago when Pete was on it, which is a very minimal amount of hours. My staff will allot to the Planning Commission each month. You can count them on one hand. If you get to four or five, that's a big one. That's not common. And then we provide that basic type of service to the Planning Commissioners to help them be effective. And that's all we were doing, and that's all that happened that month and any month prior. So yes, I did have that discussion.
So then we've been diverted by this letter and Cindy, and I can send you the email. I've tried to, I didn't bring Cindy into this. and I didn't, I haven't put anything out about Cindy, but I can, because Cindy says, "I can't imagine anybody being opposed to this if it's legal." That's a quote. And another quote is, I think you've seen her emails too, Tom. Another quote was, "I understand that there wasn't much time spent on this, and I'm glad to hear that." So before all this was sent out, they were informed of that. So why in the hell are we, excuse my friend, why are we getting a letter from the head of the Board of Commissioners request that before the Planning Commission take, I'm going to read directly so I'm not misquoting anything. The purpose of this correspondence is that the Board of Commissioners simply request that before the Planning Commission takes action to direct staff or legal to begin the preparation of UDC amendments, that the proposed concept be placed on a Board of Commissioners work session and ratified. Well, Tom just read the UDC where it says that's not the way we're supposed to do it. I've been very meticulous on trying to do this the way we're supposed to, and that is the Planning Commission may make recommendations to the board regarding amendments to the comprehensive plan and to the text of the UDC.
Where you're missing the point is directing staff and the attorney to get involved with it. They're not saying don't do it. They're saying don't direct staff and the attorney to get involved with it.
But they're and they're saying because it costs money. It didn't.
We could have simply made a motion, discussed it whenever. What my thought was on that was that in 2 months we were going to come back. You were going to be finding like some information about it so that we had enough specific that we could make a motion to carry that to the board.
And that's what I
was saying. To see if they had any interest.
Yeah, then they could draft it. I mean, we can take any sort of idea for a code amendment and send it to them for consideration.
Let me give you
another. And they can say
No, they're in control of the budget. They're not. I mean, that isn't.
This can be done for free.
That's what we wanted it to be done for.
Okay, it will.
That's fine. They're not saying that we can't do that.
Let me assure Cindy, Pete, and this board that getting this will be at little to no cost. That pretty well blunts that.
So do you have a presentation about what we were
I've had to defend. I've had to defend the diversion.
Well, I have one more thing about the diversion that I would like to bring up, because it was very disturbing to me this afternoon. This was a letter addressed to me, and you all were copied. I had not had a chance to even have any of us discuss this as a group, and it was on Facebook.
Yes, I
How
put
did
it
that
on there.
Get posted
I
on
put
Facebook?
It on there.
Why would you do that? That is disrespectful. It also, to me, is unethical. We had not even had a chance to discuss a private correspondence, and it's on Facebook.
Okay, so
I do not appreciate it. That's all I wanted to say to you.
Will you tell me what the date on that is?
The date on it is November 5th.
So you've had that since November the 5th?
Yes.
Okay. I am very concerned and upset that I'm working on this thing. You get this letter, and I found out about it this afternoon by happenstance, and that you didn't even make an effort to let me know.
All were copied on this letter. I assumed everyone had gotten
not.
The letter.
I was not copied. I did not see it. Okay.
It is right there, Forsyth County Planning Commission.
But you don't see my name on it. Let me tell you, I was not copied. Were you copied on it?
You all have it in your hands.
You all have it.
Right?
This is my copy.
You all
got it when I got here tonight.
See, I got it. So
which is why we needed to talk about it.
This was being done
in a group.
Behind my back.
No, it wasn't, Jody. It was in the work session minutes. It was a public meeting. Anybody?
Not this letter.
The
decision to write the letter. That's why I brought you what I brought you tonight from their minutes. All of that has been made public. Everything but the letter itself.
Let me tell you something.
And what it said.
Let me tell you something. That letter addressed to you from. I'm pointing at the letter. That letter, and this is what I'm all about, and you may not be about it, but that letter that Pete wrote, the minute he wrote it, That is public information. The minute you got it, it's public information. Why didn't you make it public? Well, why didn't you come to me and tell me? I'm about to apologize to you for trying to for you trying to hide a letter. She didn't contact me with it.
We were discussing it in our work session tonight.
Let me tell you, this letter has been very successful because look at us. We are diverted from talking about what the issue is.
We're not going to not talk about the issue,
but these things needed to be addressed.
Okay.
The letter was dated November 5th. I did not get the letter November 5th. I don't remember when I got the letter, but it wasn't November 5th.
Yeah, it wasn't today either.
No, it was when I addressed the planning.
You're trying to make me look bad, but the rest of us didn't get it till today.
Jody, I received the letter the night I went to the Board of Commissioners meeting to address them about the National Barbecue Cup, which was last Thursday evening.
And I was there, so why didn't you give me the
courtesy? Last Thursday evening. Because I didn't open the letter until the next day. I didn't have any idea what the letter said.
The next day, why didn't you give me the courtesy? Since you knew this was my little baby thing, why didn't you give me the courtesy of saying, I got this letter and we need to discuss it, rather than turn it around and say, you made it public.
Jody, it is a public letter. That is not what I'm doing.
Do you understand that's a public letter?
Down here where it says copy for Forsyth County Planning Commission. I assumed you all got copies of this letter.
Castigated me because of your bad assumption.
This needed to be discussed as a group with the entire planning. At the entire planning commission,
Did Cindy get herself involved in this? If it's supposed to be
because she received an email from someone about this. Yeah. That's all I know.
Are you assuming that I had something to do with that?
Why would you have something to do with that?
I don't know. It was someone else's name that she gave in the work session. I may lose all the votes, but I'm just saying,
I do not appreciate this being posted on a social media site when it was to be discussed in this public venue before any other time.
Any public record is subject to being posted anywhere.
I think you're missing what she's saying. She's not suggesting that you don't ever post it. She's suggesting that you give all of us the courtesy of discussing it with us first.
Okay, let's talk about courtesy. Talk about courtesy. I'm suggesting that she give me the courtesy of letting me know what's going on when she gets a letter. Do you think that you can speak to her about courtesy?
She thought we all had it. In fact, I spoke with her today, and she thought that we had it.
Okay, well, let me take a different tactic. I can say the same thing that Pam said. I thought everybody had it. So me posting it out there shouldn't make a difference. Because, like Pam says, everybody had it.
I mean,
we can get around the semantics with this whole
thing. What's the matter?
You know, y'all not gonna vote for what I want anyway because you don't like my attitude about it. And all I want is some openness in our government. And I want us to be able to protect ourselves from having conflicts of interest and with these corporate entities that we don't know who's in there. And we could all be at risk. I don't like the diversion. I don't like you diverting it. I don't like your diversion. I think y'all have been kind of, okay. I don't like Pete's diversion, and I don't like Cindy bringing it to the commission when I'm in the process of doing it according to the UDC. So that ought to assuage all of those problems. The bottom line is, I would like for us to vote for a little openness on these corporations and vote to send it up to the Board of Commissioners. Now, if we send it up to them, they can ignore it, they can turn it down, But they're going to need to talk about it because we sent it. Now, if we don't send it, according to Pete, they can bring it up themselves at the work session. But to do that, they're going to have two members bring it up. Two members vote to bring it, put it on the agenda. If we can send it up, they don't have to have that, and then they can step out and talk about it without having to have two members of the board having to propose it, because there's a possibility that it won't get to. And I would like for the Board of Commissioners to consider it, just like what Cindy was trying to do. Obviously, she was trying to get them to consider it. I think it was wrong the way she did it. I think that the way that this has been presented has been the legal preferred way according to the letter of the UDC, which is not to have them bring it up in a work session. It's for us. It says that we can make recommendations.
Could we have recommended that without expending any effort? I mean, could we as a body have just made a recommendation?
That's what we're doing. What kind of effort did we expend? We're spending all kinds of effort right now.
So there was no billings for that? There's no time on anybody's sheet, on the attorney's?
Let's keep the diversion going. Let's find out how.
I will divert.
Let's find out how much it costs to get this put out here, and let's find out how much it costs to produce this letter.
Are you saying that Ken did no research? He just wrote two lines
That's
in there?
Right.
He did research.
You heard. No, he didn't do research. You he heard did. Tom say he did it off the top of his head.
I think we're confident attention. It was measured in minutes, not hours.
See?
Okay.
I don't even know that we were charged. But if we were, it was very minimal. That was made clear to Cindy. That was made clear to Pete. You heard him say that. I'm pointing, I'm sorry. And it just floors me that if y'all are upset about spending $5, how about the $100 that it costs to get this letter prepared and sent?
Well, what
are y'all concerned about that?
I'm not concerned about the money spent at all.
The commissioners are.
I'm waiting to hear about your proposal.
Going to present us with something tonight. Okay.
Actually, we were going to discuss a proposal when you brought this up, and I'm trying to figure out what action are we going to be bringing. I mean, what type of
Pam
action?
Pam brought this up. It was written to Pam. She brought it up.
It was written to Pam, but you brought up the letter because you said, first, I want to talk about.
Does that matter?
Does it matter? You were saying that it was diverted from the actual content rather than going into the content first and discussing this later.
Okay. I've debunked this letter the best that I can. This letter is not relevant. It was written after the fact. It addresses issues that were not issues. And they knew they weren't issues.
So we're moving on from that.
I mean, what action?
No, he's not.
I'm saying what action is he saying
we
should do it with regard to this letter if you're concerned?
All I want to do.
We were expecting for you to present us with something tonight so that we could discuss it and then decide if we were sending it to the Board of Commissioners.
You've been presented with it. Have you read it?
I have.
Okay. I'm not in total agreement with it, but.
That's what we're suggesting.
And to allay everybody's fears. You've been told several times now that the cost of this, if there was a cost at all, was very minimal. That's the fact. That's not. Now, Pete Amos doesn't say that. And that the amount of time spent doing this to type that out probably took a couple of minutes. The amount of research on this was zero.
Which is my problem, because I thought we were.
It was done off the top of his head, just
no, I'm saying I thought you were going to bring us more information about it so that we could discuss it.
Okay, let's discuss it. What do you want to know? Here it is. What would you like to know? Because we have discussed this.
Well, I had some specific questions last time when we did kind of touch on it.
I thought we did.
My discussion, my questions, were, do any surrounding jurisdictions have used this, and you said you didn't care.
Okay, I mean, it does not matter.
I did do some research on it, and I couldn't find any adjoining jurisdictions anywhere close to us, I mean, anywhere, that used an affidavit like this.
And I asked if there could be some repercussions from this, that also Pam asked too, about planning staff time and that kind of stuff, because right now we are so limited on their time. We also asked if there was anything that, anything negative that could come from it that we might not, we just don't know about it.
Let me address that. You've gotten us away from it and gotten off on the time again, and I'm going to address that.
This is actually germane to that.
I've got another tweak to the comprehensive plan coming up in January, February. Now, are we going to have the same discussion?
We just need to talk about this. Yes, okay. I do know that.
Can I
But we
you
need
next
to
time?
Just we need to just concentrate on doing this so that we
no,
can
you're diverting
go through
again.
This.
Am I going to have to go through this again in January?
We don't know. We are not the commissioners. We cannot predict the future.
You can predict what you're going to. We have it coming up on our agenda in January, February, and it's going to cost a little
bit. I need to make a motion for like a 5-minute recess. May I have a second?
Second.
All those in favor of the motion to have a 5-minute recess, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Any opposed? That motion passes 5-1. Excuse me just a minute.
Okay, guys, I feel like I'm being attacked for trying to open up the process, and I just don't think that that's fair. And I've got another proposal coming up that I'm afraid I'm going to have the same thing. If that's going to happen, let me know, and I'll just take it off the agenda, and we won't have to go through this, particularly me. I just don't think.
You know, we don't have a quorum right now, so I don't think we need to be discussing this.
I knew someone's going to say that, but, you know, this was a big deal.
Yeah, I understand we're in recess, but I know we've had discussions about quorum, so I'm trying to be sensitive.
I understand.
Party drinks, all right.
Is there like emergency supplies?
All right. I need 3 fingers.
Oh my gosh.
9:45.
Thank you.
And the audience too, if you want some.
Oh my word.
If you think you're having a hard time, put yourself in my shoes.
You want to?
No, don't you?
Either. Thank you. I have one in the car, and I left it there because I thought I would be having that this evening with my ramen noodles, but they're cold.
You'd actually keep that. I got a couple of it here.
Thursday. Be exciting. So, you know, there's big meeting coming in. I think you're already informed of that. So, the way that it's taxed, it's one of the.
I kind of remember that because it wasn't.
what I looked for, the one that wasn't what I was looking for.
5 minutes up.
No, I don't want to put this.
Where did we get all of this?
I asked her to stay in here. I asked her some water and Tom brought out all the provisions.
You want some water?
No.
We had a training class 2 weeks ago and staff didn't want anything. They were too busy learning, I guess.
Okay, I believe my 5 minutes is up, maybe longer.
We benefited from it anyways.
Our game.
So, I'm not sure how to word this. I would like to reconvene the meeting at 9:50. I didn't give the time when I did the recess either.
It was 9:45.
Okay.
Perfect 5 minutes.
Yes, what's that?
Okay, will you read this, the proposed?
I don't want to talk about this letter anymore. I want you to go ahead and discuss this.
Okay, I'll read it. The proposed concept be placed on a Board of Commissioners work session and ratified. I'm proposing to do just that. With this, I would like to put this on the and now Pete Amos is asking us to do this.
That's fine.
And do we want to do what Pete Amos asked us to do? Do we want to put it on the work session? So I would like to make a motion that we put this amendment to the UDC on the Commissioner's work session as requested by Pete Amos, that all applications shall identify the name and applicant, and if the applicant is different from the property owner, be accompanied by a duly executed owner authorization. If either the applicant or owner are corporations, the applicant shall contain the names of the corporate stockholders, officers, and directors, unless the corporation has stock that is traded on a national stock exchange, in which case the corporate name shall be sufficient. The only change I want to make in that is the owner of corporations. I'd like to say corporate entities. So if I mumbled through it and y'all didn't understand it, it's the unique, everybody's got it right here, don't they? Or if they don't, I can give it to you. It's in red. And I can hand it to Vanessa so she'll know what's in the minute. So I make a motion that we do what the Board of Commission Chairman suggested and ask them to put this on their work session. And make a recommendation. That's what we do, is recommend. And that's according to the rule here. It says we make recommendations to the board regarding the text of the UDC, and yeah, that's what we're doing. So, who wants to vote for this?
So we have a motion. Is there a second?
Well, we haven't discussed the merits of this, so I'll second it for discussion. And I know it's a long meeting, so I apologize.
That's okay.
You apologize for seconding it?
For making the meeting longer.
For making
by seconding it?
No, that's not what happened.
I didn't put this at the end of the meeting.
Yeah. I will say, I'm very concerned about it. Some of the concerns that I have are just that if you have a corporate entity, for one, the applicant could be almost anybody. You've got a property owner, but the applicant right now is an LLC.
Hold on.
I'm sorry, I'm talking right now. Let me get my point done and then you can speak.
I'm gonna be glad it's not
the applicant is the applicant doesn't have anything beholden to them at the end of the day. The owner does. And so the applicant could actually be a third party, and that third party may even further separate any sort of disclosure. So I don't know if that achieves anything in particular. I do think that there's, you know, if you disclose a number of individuals that are in that, that exposes us to know those people. It may not be a conflict of interest, but it factors in something that's not the land use, which is what we are really supposed to be focused on. And I'm concerned about that, because in that instance, say that there's a forum or there's a group of people that say that somebody is a crook or somebody is doing something, and it's only allegations, then we run the risk of invalidating the zoning, because somebody could say, well, because that person was involved or part of that entity, and, you know, we took allegations and said, well, we don't think that they should be developing because of that. That's not really a reasonable reason for accepting or denying a zoning. So, I mean, I don't like to make land use decisions on who is involved in those land use decisions. I want those to be based on the merits of that decision.
I'm not making land use decisions. I'm trying to decide. But let me just make one comment on that.
Sure.
It's just like the sketch plan. All that I'm trying to do is get a foot in the door. This thing, by the time it goes through, it goes up the commission, assuming it's passed. It goes up to the board of commissioners. It'll come back here. And it'll go back up again. It won't be exactly that when it comes back, when after they talk about it, and it comes back. And then we may change it a little bit. So what I'm asking for there probably has nothing to do with what the final result will be. We're not going to make the final decision. The Board of Commissioners will.
Well, if they've seen it, what is the purpose of us sending it up to them if we don't agree with it, just so they'll discuss it and send it back to us? And I don't know if other people do or not, but I mean, I'm just saying, you know, if you're asking me to vote on it and I have concerns about it, I would want us to formulate something that I support to send to the board.
Tell me, what you support. Come back. I'm open.
I mean, I don't think that there's necessarily an issue right now, because right now, as the Planning Commission and as commissioners, everybody has to sign forms. The responsibility's on us to act ethically there, and I understand that.
We've got people that vote on things that need to be recusing themselves.
That's a statement. I don't know how to verify that. How do you know?
How do you know
people should be recusing themselves on things right now?
Watch me.
I'm just saying. And I will say, too, that there's a lot of other things that could involve a recusal beyond the applicant or the owner. And this is only asking for disclosure of the applicant. There is a person involved in the real estate transactions. There are people that are involved in all aspects of some of these projects. So, I mean, you can't go just by a direct interest to say that this one disclosure is going to solve any sort of potential for conflict. So I see it being onerous on the staff, and don't necessarily see that we're going to gain a huge benefit from that. I mean, that's my personal opinion.
Those are good points, and I think that was what we had. You weren't here for the last work session, so you wouldn't know this, but that's why we had wanted to discuss it further, was so that we could get some of those answers, mm-hmm. and so that we could figure out what it was we really wanted to send.
Okay.
We haven't gotten to that point yet.
Let me ask you this then. Do you want to give the Board of Commissioners an opportunity to look at this?
I'm not sure.
Do you have trouble making decisions?
I make decisions all the time.
Please
give
me
I asked for information from last time that we haven't received, and we were waiting for a presentation.
Let's get back to that
we haven't gotten to, and so those are my concerns.
Okay, so I'm being led to believe, from what I've heard,
that y'all don't want to give the Board of Commissioners an opportunity.
I don't think that's up for discussion. I think if we're gonna make the motion, let's make the motion and vote on it.
Well, he made the motion and he seconded it.
I mean, the.
Are we done with our discussion?
Well, I'll leave you out.
I mean, to vote for it is an endorsement of it. When we make a recommendation to the board, would I recommend something that I don't necessarily think?
Well, y'all recommended that we draw it up. I mean, the five people, four, maybe you weren't, recommended that we send it to get it drawn up for me to present.
Well, and we have differing opinions about what we were asking.
Okay.
I mean, this is very clear and concise. So I think it makes it easy to.
It's not one or two pages like you were thinking it was going to be.
No, because I thought I was going to be getting some more information. I thought you were going to be presenting the reasonings behind it and your arguments for it.
You can call the question because the writing's on the wall and this thing, I understand. I mean, this is fine.
It's not a personal thing, Joey.
No, it's not a personal thing, but I hope that y'all feel the same way when other people in this room bring up things that may cost a little bit of time.
This is not about cost for me. This is about not.
It's about cost for Pete Amos.
Well, I'm not about me.
Okay. So y'all want me just to sit here and be quiet when y'all bring something up that is of concern to you all?
No, we wanted you to bring to us.
I did. I presented it, and I've had to go through almighty hell.
My only argument was that this was not
what you wanted to see.
In my opinion.
That's fine.
Well, we have a motion and a second. All those in favor of the motion, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye.
I move that we adjourn the meeting.
That motion fails 4-1 with Commissioner Bowman, Commissioner Neal, Commissioner Nolan, and Commissioner Iglesias opposed, and Commissioner Moses in favor.
Make a motion that we adjourn the meeting.
I'll second that motion. All those in favor of the motion, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion to adjourn the meeting passes 5-0. The meeting is adjourned at 10:02 p.m.
Y'all understand, I'm not mad at anybody on this discipline. I think y'all made a tragic mistake. But that's just my opinion, as I dealt with it, and I'm disappointed in you guys.
Good night. Have a good night.
Thank you.
Good evening. Thanks.
I'm not mad at you.
Either one, but I like the spicy.
I'm just real passionate about this.
Yeah, I'll see you in a week. All right, yeah, we'll see you next week.
Thank you.